Hi. In this video, I'm going to solve a question which came in IIT-JEE 2005. In this question, it will cover the a different type of velocity graph, basically velocity versus displacement graph, and we are going to solve for acceleration. We will solve the acceleration, the variation of acceleration with displacement x. So let's see how to approach this problem. Now here, since we don't have our usual Vt graph, in which we just differentiate v with respect to t and we get a. So that graph would be a versus t. Now here, since we have to find a versus x relationship, so we have to find some other relationship that will relate a, v and x. So we can do one thing. Some of you might know this relationship, or we can derive it again. So if v is a function of x, as in this case, so we will differentiate it first with respect to x, and then x will be differentiated with respect to t. This is just a chain rule, simple. So this will lead us to, this will become v, this is the current v, and this will remain as it is. Okay, now here we can easily see, some of you who has a good understanding of graphs, they can understand that simple dv by dx is nothing but the slope of this graph, and since this angle is obtuse, so we can say that this slope will be negative. And if this slope is negative, so a will be directly proportional to minus v. So whatever v I have, a will be just the negative of it. So I can say at x equals 0, v is v naught, or we can say, let's make a table out of it, a, v and x. If x is 0, v is positive, so I can say from this formula that a will be negative. Now which one amongst them will give a negative at x equals 0? That will be this, this, as well as d. Okay, so this rules out this one. Now at x equals x naught, our velocity is 0, so apparently acceleration will be 0 as well, which will be satisfied only in this one. So we have the answer. We have the answer A. But we should understand this question analytically as well. So we'll see how to approach it analytically now. So analytically, what do we mean by analytically? Analytically, we will find the equation of the line, and then we will put it in the formula that we derived just now. We'll put it here and we will come to know, right, the acceleration. For that, first I'll let you know how to find the equation of line. We need to find the relationship between v and x first. So in general, if we have a line, then how do we approach it? We can approach it by equating two slopes. Okay, if I have, let's say I have two points, y1, x1 and y2, x2. Okay, and I need to find the value of y at some x, which is in between them. Then what do I do? I will, the slope of a line y equals mx plus c, this will be the slope which will be given by dy by dx, or y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So the slope will be, this is the slope, tan theta. How do you find tan theta? This by this. Right, and this will be given by y2 minus y1 and this will be given by x2 minus x1. So this is the slope. Now, since it's a straight line, so the slope will be equal at any time, right? The slope here will be equal to the slope here. So what I'll do is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1 will be equal to y minus y1 upon x minus x1. Where y1, y2, x1, x2, these are all the given values. Now in our question, it is given that at v equals v naught, x is 0, and at x equals x naught, v is 0. So this will be my y1, this will be my y, and this will be my x. Alright, I'll put that in this equation. So y1 and y2, y2 will be 0 and y1 will be v0, x2 is x0 and this is 0. This will be y minus v0 upon x minus 0. Hope I'm not making any mistakes. So we'll get the relation v0 and this x plus v0 will be equals y. Now from this equation as well, you can see that the multiplier of x is this quantity, which is a negative one, since v0 and x0 are positive. So we can say that it is negative. The slope m is negative. And we said in last, we said earlier also that since it's an obtuse angle, the slope will be negative only, right? Now we'll put this into this equation here, and we will try to find the acceleration now. So acceleration will be nothing but dv by dx, which is, so we have dv by dx here, right? So it will be minus v naught by x naught into v. So if you put to x equals 0, you should get a equals minus v naught square by x naught. So this is pretty much a negative quantity. And if you put x equals x naught, you will get acceleration as 0. So this will be satisfied by, with the help of our first option. And the other option rules out. So this is pretty much that I wanted to tell you. I hope this video helps. Thank you. Comment in the comment section below for more doubts. Hope you like the video. Thank you.